Hello, and welcome to the Continental eAccess Technical Introduction video. This video is an introduction video and will not cover the configuration of the eAccess controllers in detail. Please refer to the complete series of eAccess videos for detailed configuration information. In addition to this video, please reference the eAccess documents located in the Continental Document Library. The Continental Document Library can be found at www.cicaccess.com. Then click Resources and then Support and Technical Library. In the Document Library, click Product Type and then click eAccess. Under eAccess, there will be multiple documents available, including the 1-door, 2-door, and 4-door installation guides. These guides are very useful regarding the wiring of the controllers. In addition to the installation guides, you will find a complete eAccess user guide and wiring diagrams. The 2- and 4-door wiring diagrams are located on the door of the controller. The Continental eAccess system is a hybrid system. It provides the best of all technology options, including secure off-site cloud, mobile app, and on-premise management. The eAccess controllers contain an embedded Linux operating system and is browser managed, with no software to load. It also includes an integrated web server and mobile app management. The eAccess software also contains an easy-to-follow configuration wizard. The eAccess controllers are available in 1-door, 2-door, and 4-door models. These controllers do not support PoE. The eAccess embedded single-door controller supports 1-door with 2 readers, 1 reader for in and 1 reader for out. In addition, it contains 2 relays, 1 for the door lock and 1 for the auxiliary relay. It also contains 3 inputs, 1 for REX, 1 for door position switch, and 1 auxiliary input. For complete wiring details, refer to the 1-door controller wiring diagram. The wiring diagram will display in detail each wire and their descriptions. The 1-door controller contains 2 connectors, a 14-pin reader harness and a 10-pin power harness. Please take note of the power requirements that can be found in the installation guide. Continental offers an optional PoE power supply that can provide up to 2 amps and can be wired into the plus 12 volt and ground inputs. Very important, this option is not for PoE and does not plug in to the Ethernet jack. Again, it is only used as an external power supply. The eAccess embedded 2-door controller supports 2 doors with 2 readers on each door. In addition, it contains 4 relays, 2 for door locks and 2 for auxiliary relays. It also contains 3 inputs for each door. 1 for REX, 1 for door position switch, and 1 auxiliary input. The wiring diagram for the 2 and 4-door controllers are the same wiring diagram, with the differences noted with asterisks. The 2-door controller is also available with a power package that includes power for door locks. The power module has additional connectors on it to provide lock power and has connections for a backup battery. The 2-door controller can also be expanded to a 4-door controller by adding a 2-door expansion board. Refer to the detailed mounting instructions in the 2- and 4-door installation manual. After mounting the 2-door expansion board to the 2-door controller, you must license the expansion board using the license screen. The eAccess embedded 4-door controller supports 4 doors with 2 readers on each door. In addition, it contains 8 relays, 4 for door locks and 4 for auxiliary relays. It also contains 3 inputs for each door, 1 for REX, 1 for door position switch, and 1 auxiliary input. The 4-door controller is also available with a power package that includes expanded power for door locks. All eAccess controllers can be configured as either a server or a client to expand the amount of doors in the system. eAccess system supports from 1 to 128 doors and up to 64 panels or controllers. All systems require 1 server. In addition to the server, you configure additional controllers as clients or elevators to increase the number of doors or elevators. The options enabled in the eAccess license key determines how many clients are supported and also which features are enabled in the system. When configuring a client, you must specify the IP address of the server. the client's point to the one server. The eAccess controller is a network-ready appliance. All that is required is to take the controller out of the box, mount the controller, connect to a network, and provide power. The eAccess controller defaults to a 192.168.0.250 IP address, with a subnet mask of 255.255.255.0. Connect a computer directly to the Ethernet port of the controller. A standard Cat5 cable is used for a direct connection. A crossover cable is not required. Assign a static IP address to the computer of 192.168.0.210 with a subnet mask of 255.255.255.0. Again, this is on the computer. Upon matching subnets, there are two methods to access the controller. The first method is to type the controller IP address into a supported browser. Again, the factory default IP address of the controller is 192.168.0.250. Open a web browser such as Google Chrome and enter the default IP address into the address bar. If it is successful, the eAccess login screen should display. If you are unable to access the controller using a browser, the second method would be to download the Smart IP Finder utility from the Continental Document Library. The Smart IP Finder utility is used to search for the eAccess controllers. Install the Smart IP Finder utility on the computer that is connected directly to the controller. Click Scan. Upon searching and finding your controller, you can use a Smart IP Finder utility to program in a static IP address into the controller that meets your network address scheme. Reminder: a static IP address must be used on a server controller. Client controllers may use DHCP, but if possible, also configure them with a static IP. Very important: if you are unable to find a controller with the previous methods, each controller contains three reset buttons. One is to perform a hardware reset. The second is to reset the IP address back to the default IP address. And the third is to perform a factory default. If all else fails, it would be recommended to perform an IP reset to set the IP address back to 192.168.0.250. Upon resetting the IP address back to the default address, repeat the steps above. Reminder: the above procedures are also explained in the One Door Quick Start Guide and the installation guides. Upon the eAccess login screen displaying, log in with the default credentials of ID equals admin and password equals admin. Upon logging in for the first time, the license page will display. To get a license key, first click on the Edit button. The license key is tied to the MAC address of the eAccess controller. The MAC address can be found on the box the controller was received in and also on the physical controller. It is required to have internet access to download the license key to the controller. Controllers can be licensed as a server, client, or elevator. As per the license screen displaying, click on A, the Get License Key for a server, or click on B, the Get Client Key for a client. Click OK to confirm, and the license key will be auto-populated. Finish by clicking C, Apply License Key, and the controller will restart. Upon licensing the controller, the eAccess Content Wizard will display. If the controller is currently licensed and you want to add a feature, please contact your Continental Regional Sales Manager and also reference the How to Upgrade Your License document in the Continental Document Library. Very important: after the controller is licensed, it is highly recommended to take a screenshot of the license screen with the license key number for future reference. Again, all the information above is available in the eAccess documentation. This concludes the eAccess introduction video. Please refer to the next video in the series for detailed information regarding configuring the eAccess software using the wizard. For more information on eAccess, please contact Continental Access Sales.